So I hope you enjoy the class.
Get some knowledge.
Probably update your previous or your background. Some have background in finance already. So I hope you can get a new
knowledge or widen your knowledge in finance from taking this class. Okay. For those who don't have background in finance, so what can I say? But all of you have the prerequisite, the financial strategy with Ajahn Manapun.
Ajahn.
No, finance strategy.
Rumkia.
Oh, principal of finance.
Yes.
With the Ajahn Rumkia.
Yeah.
And the other one, finance strategy.
Ajahn
Tanya. Okay. So there shouldn't be any problem. Okay. So that we can gain deeper level of knowledge, which is so. But what I expect from you is you should be able to get at least B, right? B. And we're gonna have like a guest speaker, two guest speakers. I wish you be here when we have guest speaker. It's not easy to invite him to speak to you here, so I wish you can come on that day. All of you. And we also have like a case study, group project as well. Okay. And that should be with us. So, you know what is private equity? Anyone can tell us? What is private equity? What is fintech? What is alternative investment? You can ask Alexa. Who is Alexa? Alexa, you know Google's assistant.
Google.
You can ask for Tana. You can ask Siri. Who is Siri? Siri. Okay, Siri can be paid by electronic bill for this month. Cortana, can you order a pizza from me? Thing like that, right? So we come to the new age of AI, right? And then so things change rapidly. So what is private equity? Anyone know? What is fintech? So you're gonna find here in our class, okay? Anyone who has background in finance, you should know what is efficient market, how it looks like if you get it from the company. What is efficient market? How do you know that this market is efficient?
Fully looking information.
In what? Okay, what reflect information? Yeah, information is correct, but in what?
In historical data.
In the price. Okay, so it means no one can get benefit from past
information,
public information, or even inside information was strong form. That is efficient. However, what does efficient mean in the economy? Efficient. So that is finance, correct? What about you? investment in finance. Traditional in finance, when we say investment, you can think about real asset or physical asset, right? You can type such one example, buy a house, you invest in land, equipment, and factory, things like that, but it's physical investment. What about financial investment? Traditional. One stock, or you're selling in a bank. What about? Alternative. That traditional one, right? One stock, you know, one, you know, stock. Derivative. It more and more become normal. Okay. But what they call the alternative, it actually is nothing new, but it's not like bond stock, it's like a commodity, exchange trade fund, or REIT, you know, REIT, REIT, what does it stand for?
REIT. The funder in the property.
Yeah, in property or infrastructure fund, thing like that. That is alternative investment. So what I'm saying here, we're gonna find in our course, okay, during that together here. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are all here already. At 6:19. It's okay. Yeah. Okay. So I heartily welcome you again. Okay. if it did not
listed,
not listed on the stock exchange. Okay, there are two things. If you are a small business and you want to expand your inventory or expand your investment, you want to buy goods, you want to buy inventory, and you need the money. Okay. So when you get, if you are a small company, okay, there are two ways. First, you can go to the bank. Or second, you can sell a share to investment company, something like that. Or probably you can sell all of your company to others, something like that. You're gonna learn it here, private equity. And VC or venture capital will cover you this part as well. And then come back to me again. Okay, we're gonna talk about money market and capital market. What the difference between the two? They are in the market, but why is money, why is capital? What the difference? Can anyone tell? Money market, the capital market. Okay, when in economy, when we call capital, when we say capital, what does it mean? Capital.
Long-term investment.
Okay. And it can be like a physical asset, right? And financial asset as well. So what your friend say is long-term. So in other words, in contrast, money is short term. How short? How long? What is the borderline between short and long? Is it in Bangkok and is it in Sumatra? Now, as I said, in the same market, but different product. So less than 1 year and more than 1 year. If it's less than 1 year, we call it money market. If it's more than 1 year, we call it capital market. So in this case, can you give me an example? Okay, for easier one, capital market, what? Before we go to that part, market, can anyone tell me what the meaning of buy exchange goods and services. You have a buyer, seller, and product.
Right.
Buy, seller, and product. Okay. So generally, buyer and seller are the same person for both market. The difference is the product inside. Okay. Can you give me an example of capital market? The product. Categorized into capital market. Bonds.
Long-term bonds.
Stock is a chart along. Stock share of the company.
It's
long.
It's
long. If you say the stock in chart, no one can go to buy it,
right?
Because we call it indefinite life for stock. Because the company must go on indefinitely. If you have the end period of the stock, how will people expect that, okay, this company is going to so bankrupt or something like that. So we think that is indefinite life for stock, but bond, that is a definite life for the bond. Stock is definite life. So all of them, two of them are long term. What about mortgage? What does it mean, mortgage?
It's not like house.
House, yes, house. Is it long or short?
Long.
Long. Of course, long. Okay. Commodity. Commodity.
Normally short
and normally a kind of
price is driven by demand and supply.
Yeah.
Mostly, no standard.
Yeah. And normally, is it homogeneous or heterogeneous? What about when you are with Ajahn Rungkia and can you tell?
Huh?
For example,
Rungkia
does not.
How many examples?
Rungkia
example,
I think it's 40 questions.
for Paul, how many class? One?
One. Probably one and a half.
Okay, one and a half.
Actually, it's just a background. If you have finance or economic background, it's all in here already. Or it could, more or less, it's about economics. Interest rate, intermediation, central bank, monetary policy. Also, if you have background in that one, you should be okay for this one. But if you don't have a background on in finance, you can read the textbook. Oh, Jack, during you are on a flight to Cambodia. You can read.
It's only 45 minutes.
Okay, so this is what
we're gonna cover in the next week.
Okay, any question regarding to our learning plan here? Okay. So who gonna create a live group? Okay, so give me your.
I have to add you, right?
Yeah.
What is your current name?
You want this because.
พี่เพชรอ่านไงหลังจากสอบเสร็จยังไม่อ่านใช่ไหม
นอนครับผม
นอน
มาทำอะไรอยู
่ครับผมมาทำอะไรอยู่ยังไม่ได้ได้เซ็นเลย
ไม่ใช
่
อ
่
ะ
ฮะ
ดูเกียร์เกียร์แบบ
นี้อาจจะเกียร์นั้นยังมึน
รูปอ๋อ you can invite
อาจารย์ดี
actually you can share rooBritain, right?
city that may replace Hong Kong? What do you think?
Singapore.
Or what's this?
Shanghai.
Or
Tokyo.
Japan. Tokyo. Okay, big one. The next one, on the headline, every day's news, is a trade war, right? Trade war between Beijing and Washington. Who is the president of the U.S.? Mr. Trump. During his campaign, he
they spend more than they earn, right? Probably they want to invest, or probably they want to buy goods and services. Okay, let me talk about here. Yeah.
So it on asset or liability?
Asset.
Asset, so it's prepaid. And others. Okay, that is short-term asset. So how are we gonna finance this kind of thing here? Come from here, short-term liability. For example, AR, you have account receivable, you have account payable, right? Account payable, right? You have short-term loan or note payable, note payable. All of payable should be here. You also have what else that you should have here? So you can issue like commercial paper to borrow in the short term, so it's all that non payable here. Okay. Or you can borrow, get a revolving credit from the bank. Then you can write check, unlimited to the check writing. Okay. So accrual here. Or approval here as well, and others. Okay. So this is a finance on the account that we're going to learn here during the 8 week together. Okay. We have money market, we have capital market here, stock, long term debt. And it can be bond as well. May I ask you, if you have, if you start a company, can you borrow the money by issuing the bonds?
Yes.
You know that you can borrow from the bank, right? But alternatively, you can issue bonds as well. If you start a company, can you issue bonds? No one bought, right? And probably it's illegal as well, because it must, it's like consumer protection. And they can think of it like a, is it a Ponzi scheme, thing like that, okay, it's a fraud, thing like that. So before you can issue a bond, you can have like a credit agency, investment banking, thing to help you in this kind of thing. So this is what we're going to cover in this course here, finance. Okay, but, okay, this is what we talk about here. And we talk about surplus and spending. Another picture that I would like to draw here is what is the formula? What is the classic formula for GDP? C plus I plus
G
plus
net S.
So C is?
C is consumption
expenditure. Consumption expenditure. Normally, who expend? What is I?
Private investment.
Investment. What is T? Government. Government can be both expenditure and investment as well, but is spent by government, I by private. X is export, M is
import,
S minus M is net export, right? Okay. So normally, how
like a 1, 2, 3, 4
person here. Yeah.
If you look at your slide, if you look at the slide here, yeah. You see that one household, business, government, and foreign investor here on both sides. Okay, on both sides here. Okay, that we call it the sector. Household sector, business sector, government sector, foreign investors. Okay. And then, okay, if Chin Chok Chai, you know what is Chin Chok Chai? Huh? Jed? You know that? Chin
yeah.
Chok Chai, okay. You know, they want to. Did you register for that? Not yet, it's too late now. Yeah. Okay, I registered and it's success, but my friends, they're not recommending my friends. Okay. Chin Chok Chai is where spending 1,000 at Bao Ta app, you know, Bao Ta app. It's an application in mobile phone, the Play Store. Bao Ta, government will put it in Bao Ta app for you, and then you can scan QR code, spend that 1,000 at Chin Chok Chai shop. Okay. So household spending, we are government sponsorship. Okay. Is it increased GDP? Yes, Chin Chok Chai, yes. Because we have a formula GDP. Here, you're going to see, C is the first consumption. Okay. So, we have a problem that household not spend their money. Okay. If you go to the department store, big department store, not many people buy things like that. What is the problem of our economy? How will not spend their money, right? No one buys goods, probably less than they spend. Okay. So they're trying to stimulate spending, household spending. But the thing is, a lot of debt that household owns as a percentage of GDP, high debt, household debt. Okay. What about business? If they invest, it's an I.
No.
I. Right?
Yes.
Government spending, government investment is a G. Right? And S log N, S minus N. Yeah, they go back. Okay, they're on both sides. Okay, and normally the surplus is, the majority of the surplus is the ultimate saver. Okay. The households is a majority sector on the surplus unit. And on deficit unit, business and the majority will borrow. So how fund flow from surplus to deficit here? How fund flow from those who have more saving than spending to those who want money or deficit. There are two channels we call direct and indirect. Okay. Direct financing up here and indirect here. Okay. For direct finance, normally, okay, you may think that, okay, you know whom you're going to borrow from. For example, I want 5,000 and ask, okay, can you give me 1,000? Can you give me 500? Can you give me until you get 500? business want to borrow the money, where is private financing, they can issue bond, they can issue share or sell their share to get the money. So if you look at this picture here, business, household, people here, especially business and government here, they can issue bond. And also they can issue share, or we call it stock. They just know that this money from this bank, and that's it. So bank play an important role as a financial intermediary. Okay. So that not only bank is here, as I say, there's non-bank as well, insurance, credit union, or even mutual fund in investment company, finance company, things like that here. So this is the flow of the fund from deficit surplus to deficit here. Okay. So now I guess you can differentiate chair of PTT. You are an owner, part of an owner of PTT chair, right? If you want to be the owner of PTT, so you keep on buying, until you get the majority of the share, so you get your PTT is belong to you then. You can chair the board of director, you can vote those people out and then take your people in as a board of director. So, you know, you understand that you can buy a company via stock exchange, right? By you keep on buying their shares, and then when you are the majority of the share, you can vote. Have your own board of director, and then you set the old one. Okay. There are many companies taken on the stock exchange. And in Thailand, there's a big company. They usually buy other companies on the stock exchange, and they become bigger and bigger and bigger. Which one? By using this way, we call this cost time, and you buy from up from it. Which company? Bigger and bigger, they buy other companies on the stock exchange. As starting as SCT. Oh my god! Oh god, I didn't notice that. That's city. Okay, so you know. Okay, that's the one. Many companies, you know, I know one company that SCT buy. It belongs to an Indian family. Finnick is a paper factory. Finnick at Concat. It used to Indian family is the owner of that one. And then one day they listed on the exchange and then they were bought by SCT, and then go back to Indian now. Okay, that's the thing. So, okay, that's another story. So equity is here, what is here? Right. So debt and equity here. So this is debt or liability. This is equity. PE ratio here. Okay. So in the financial system here. Okay. And then I said that. Okay, for financial engineering. The lower part, okay, the lower part here, I probably would like to go on the upper part first, financial market. The financial market here, what we say here, and we have already talked about But thing is, the surplus comes to the bank. Oh, sorry, let me say, borrow from the bank and then let me go to this one. Okay, so if you look at the slide here, incomplete or asymmetric between between buyer and seller, between two parties. Okay, we call it adverse selection. The other one, moral hazard, normally happens after transaction. Give example of moral hazard. For example, if insurer get your car, insurer probably you drive quicker, faster, and not too careful about your behavior. Okay. But if your insurance is out, how you drive your car? you may be afraid of get collision, things like that. So that is a moral hazard. The other example is that for this one, company or people who get the money already, they may not use the money the way that can produce more income that will repay the debt. They have like a misbehavior here as well, so it's a moral hazard. Okay. Or CEO act not the best interest. Okay, it's a moral hazard. The other word about financial intermediary that people talk about in finance is the word principal, right? Normally it's mean about manager or CEO. Okay. CEO for the public. The moral hazard.
Yeah.
For the public company, normally where is CEO from? When you get CEO, the company
employed by one of them.
Yeah. Things like that. Interest of share.
principal agent Robert is a kind of moral hazard as well. Okay, so who is the principal shareholder here? Is the principal, and who is the agent?